Scrapman69. I watched your video. Vacuum one. Check this one out, bro. I think we have a match. But Scrap Hounds, we need to see something a little different. Now we gotta find ourselves something new. What the hell? Something new to tear apart. Change plans. What have we here? That bread maker? I think another bread maker. No, not a bread making day. Printer? Copier? Nah. Computers? Now that could be fun. Broken skill saw? Got lots of vacuums. That'll be for another day. See? Some of these do work though. Ooh, it's a bright one. What's that, Dan? Nice junk? It'd be nice to see this junk gun. Tools of the trade. Oh, yes! I will be using my new power bar today. Should be exciting. A stack of monitors. A couple towers. Must be another VCR, yep. I got this water heater down here too. Tear that apart, couple lamps. Lamps are fun, I gotta get them out of the way. I think it's a... what day? It's lamp day! Yeah! Bada boom, lights. We got lights here, we got lights there, we got lights. So what I'll do with each of the lamps prior to starting is flip them over. Some of them will have like a felt cover on the bottoms. So, and if they do, I'm just take that and just pull that away. I'll stand off to the side. And that exposes the bottom piece. Can be a little nut up inside of them. So then you can take your pair of your cutters and just cut that cord nice and close. And get rid of the rest of the cord. Set that there. Take the cord end off. I throw those into a bucket for plug soup. That's just the garbage tag on it. So we'll just toss cords down to the side here. Now we got that off. Like I say, we can just pair of pliers in there. And sometimes they come loose real easy. Sometimes they give you a little bit of a fight. But also taking them off like that, you could use a socket or wrench as well. But little magnetic dish to throw nuts and washers, screws and stuff in, too. Take that right off there. A little washer. Ah, what a mess. So anyway, this is just a concrete weight to give the base of the lamp some weight. That'll go for shred. See if the rest of this turns off easily. Yep, there we go. So then, in this lamp, a little bit of a threaded tube. And the rest of this is just a plastic resin, if you will, I suppose. Now there is a steel bar that runs up inside there. So you can take and you can bust that stuff down with a hammer, whatever have you. Put it in a bag or, you know, old pillowcase. Saves busted pieces from flying around. Always make sure you're wearing safety glasses. And, yeah, so that's for that piece. Oh, there they are. Actually, I want to get rid of the plastic on off switch. And these guys, they come off pretty easy. Just give them a little squeeze. These little slider tabs here, pop off of those guys. They come off nice and easy. So in here, there's a little screw right on the bottom. See if this, yeah, that'll work somewhat. Not as fast as a screwdriver, but I guess this just shows, you know, you guys can pull lights apart with minimal tools. I'm gonna just unthread that. There's the top of your light, rest of the copper. These pieces here. This is just all basically your shred. And even that, yeah, that's all metal. So you can throw that into your shred. I did have some shred piles going over there. Same as that thread is done. On top here, now every once in a while there'll be a brass top that sort of holds your lampshade down. And grab your magnet. This is a neodymium magnet, so it gives you your best pull. Nothing sticking. This magnet there, hit it with a file. Take the glasses off so you can see a little easier. And that's definitely a metallic, so it's not brass. Which is alright. You know, that can go into your, hit it with a grinder afterwards, and if it sparks, then it'll be stainless steel. If it doesn't spark, it'll be aluminum. It's got a bit of weight to it, so I doubt that it's aluminum. These guys here. Yeah, that's all just shred. So then getting down to the rest of your power wire here. Your lamp plug in. Just kind of get in there. Usually they pop apart pretty easy. Of course, anytime you want to put something on video, things want to fight a little bit. And this guy is nice and light. You can bend it pretty easy. Take a file. If your file bites into it as well, really easy, harder to push into, pretty good chance that it's aluminum. No stickage. So I'll throw that in a little bucket down there. Same thing here. And this aluminum here, this would be a dirty aluminum. You can clean that up. There's a sticker stuck around with the wattage, right? Peel that off. There's a little bit of cardboard up inside that you'd have to take out. Of course, I squeezed it. There we go. Sticker stuck to me. But anyway, yeah, inside here there's a piece of cardboard. Fish that out. I don't want to take too much time on that. Down for the rest of this where your cord end is. If you have something like a little bit pokey, of course they don't, there, that's not sharp enough. You can just take the wire, cut it off there. That gives you your power cable. That would be a 60% copper recovery, as there's one layer of insulation. If you would want to, you could also strip that down. It's a stranded wire, thin strands. Can be a pain, but that is up to you. Now on the rest of these guys, this piece around here will be some aluminum. And just some plastic. There's some brass pieces, a bit of copper up inside of them. And see, I save those and then I sit down. I've got a small bucket or whatever that's, you know, full of these guys. So I'll sit and pull them apart in the evenings. But that gets one done. And we'll move on to the rest. I got 9 more lights to do. Let's speed this up and get back to it. This one is like a ceramic, and the threaded bar runs through the ceramic. And I don't really want to smash the ceramic too much, so you get the copper out of there and see if this will turn at all. As you grab with a pair of pliers, you can get them to thread. You say, I don't want this to break out here, just because this is the backyard. Nope, that one doesn't want to play. So we will set this one to the side. Like I said, take them, put them in like an old pillowcase, and smash it with a hammer, and you can get that metal bar out of there. And that contains all the broken ceramic, or if they're glass. We'll set that one off to the side. Dig into the next one, which is exactly the same. So we'll go back into speedo mode. Well, scrap hounds, if you enjoyed this lamp teardown, me getting a little bit of stuff cleaned up, wasn't a whole lot. Like I say, I had that vacuum video planned out. Thanks, scrap man. That was awesome. I chuckled the whole way through. Anyway, smash the like button. I pulled this one out of the seat of my pants because, like I said, I had a vacuum video planned. Anywho, if you guys aren't already subscribed to the channel, button's down there, click it, there'll be a little bell that pops up, click all notifications, jingle that bell, helps the channel, it lets you know when I drop a new video, so that you guys can enjoy it, and let me know down below what you liked, what you didn't like about this. What are we gonna call it? Right, fly by the seat of my pants video. We'll catch you in the next one. Cheers.